NewsChannel.com. We'll let you know how that goes. Welcome back. Nurses are used to dealing with stressful situations like that, and an Allenburg woman has been getting a lot of praise for those skills, for helping a toddler suffering from heat exhaustion during a terrifying flight from North Carolina tonight. Well, tonight we hear the story from her firsthand. Here's Anya Hunneke.
Nicole Palardy arrived at Burlington International Airport in Vermont Tuesday morning for the first leg of her trip to Texas, the same trip she made a few days earlier in reverse, a trip now burned into her memory.
It was very scary.
Last Friday, Palardy was on a U.S. Airways flight from Charlotte, North Carolina to Philadelphia. Takeoff was delayed, and when the plane did leave, she says the air conditioning was not working well.
It was 115 degrees in the back.
About a half hour into the sweltering and turbulent flight, she recalls, the captain announced the plane would be making an emergency landing back in Charlotte.
A minute later, a lady rushed her, I would say he was 2 years old, up to the front saying he was unresponsive. At that time, I just jumped right out of my seat. I said, I'm a nurse.
Palardy, 24, is from Allenburg, Vermont, currently on active duty in San Antonio, Texas. She says her military training helped her stay focused amidst the chaos.
Everyone was terrified.
And treat the patient.
He was hot to touch. I removed all of his clothes and asked the attendants to hand me ice so that I could apply them to the main blood vessels.
She says supplies were limited and nerves were shot.
I only did what I could with what I had.
But the boy gradually came around and was taken immediately to the hospital once the plane landed. Palardy doesn't know who they are, but knows they're grateful.
Could you tell, even amidst the chaos, that she was thankful?
She thanked me every time she saw me throughout that airport as she was bringing the child to the emergency room.
Palardy was on her way back to Vermont to be with her family. Her grandfather had passed away 3 days earlier, and the memorial service was scheduled for Saturday.
I know that my grandfather would be so proud of me.
She returns home with that assurance and the knowledge that somewhere out there a little boy is, in large part, alive and well because of her. In South Burlington, Anya Hunneke, News Channel 5.